evening, ladies and gentlemen, coming to you live from the outskirts of the internet. This is the Gaming Saloon, day two of the E3 2015 special. As hell froze over last night for Sony, and unfortunately no one could follow up on that hell freezing over today.
Nope.
So I can't do my opening monologue about receiving a weather report from hell.
Oh, we still received a weather report from hell. It's just it wasn't the weather report we needed.
No. So, we're recovering Sony from last night.
And oh my god.
Recovering Nintendo and Square Enix from today, and fucking hell, Square Enix was boring, and Nintendo wasn't the best in the world, but that's probably because, A, they do Nintendo Directs all the time, so they don't have all the big announcements, like, waiting in the wings, and B, there wasn't that much interesting to talk about with Nintendo Direct itself.
Nah, there wasn't. There really wasn't.
And there's some miscellaneous stuff I grabbed to talk about, and that was about it. Because no one has any proper demos or any proper information on anything else today, apparently.
Other than, holy hell, The Last Guardian is a thing.
Oh, so that's
finally a thing.
Oh, well, no, it was a thing back in the day because they had a demo then, too.
Yeah. And then it went into freaking limbo hell.
And no, they had to go back to the drawing board and literally remake the game from the ground up. Which is funny because it looks like the exact same game.
Why did they have to remake it from the ground up?
Fuck if I know. That was like last year or the year before.
It's just like everybody, it's been for the past couple E3s.
6 years.
Everybody's just been, Last Guardian, it's coming this year. It's coming this year. Where is the Last Guardian? It became a joke, for God's sake.
Not as big as a joke as Duke Nukem. Or Kingdom Hearts 3. Granted, we all knew the reason for Kingdom Hearts 3, and we could all blame it on Final Fantasy 13.
Yep.
True.
Final Fantasy 13 can go burn in hell.
And for those wondering, that's not a joke. That is legitimate. You can blame Final Fantasy 13 for having Kingdom Hearts 3 wait around for a fucking, like... When was Kingdom Hearts 2 released?
2006?
Why we have to wait almost a decade for the game to be potentially released? Because for those who don't know the story, essentially, you know that Final Fantasy, you know Versus 13 that then became 15 2 years ago?
Uh-huh.
Well, the Kingdom Hearts team was on that game. That game was announced when 13 got announced. It was supposed to be a part of the Fabiano's Nova Crystallis series of games that were all 13 games. So 13 versus 13, and then Agito 13, that then became Type Zero, and Versus 13 became 15 2 years ago. But the Kingdom Hearts team were on that game. And it was stated by Nomura himself that Kingdom Hearts 3 can't start development until Versus 13 is done.
Because, you know, reasons.
Right, because it's the same development team.
Yeah.
That's why we got 1,001 spinoffs for Kingdom Hearts until now, nearly a decade later, we can finally fucking get Kingdom Hearts 3.
Right.
That is why that's why 2 years ago, I was just happy Kingdom Hearts 3 was in development. It's just like it's now in development. I don't fucking care. There doesn't need to be a release date at this point, in my opinion, because fuck. It took us so long to get here. I'm fucking waiting. I'm just gonna be patient.
So, oh boy, what's Rod Ferguson doing over here?
I do believe someone forgot to update the dashboard.
I updated the fucking dashboard. I hit that button.
The button didn't update.
Stupid button!
I hit the button. I swear to God, I hit the button. I hit that update
button. The button didn't update. Still says we're done day one.
Well, here's the thing. It's supposed to say day two.
You didn't change the two.
I did not change the one to the two. Everything else was up to date.
Bravo!
Fantastic. This is what happens when you put me in charge of streaming TGS.
Freaking bravo.
Hey, hey, you update the dashboard anyhow. I've not updated the site, though. Unless you did.
I didn't, because I didn't think about it, because I never think about updating the website until you remind me to do so.
Yeah.
Or I randomly...
I got it! Right, I never...
Oh, God. What did you never do?
What happened there? I don't even... I don't know.
Oh, God.
I don't know what went... I know what happened. I didn't copy. Okay, I got it. Whoops.
Anyway, let's get into fucking E3 stuff properly.
Okay,
Sony had their press conference last night at 9 o'clock, and Glock was happy to do emergency, like, hold on, we gotta talk about this stuff from the press conference.
That's why it took so long to actually start it.
Yeah, because someone didn't believe me when I said, it's fucking Last Guardian, it's Last Guardian, it's Last Guardian. You know what happened when I watched it? I immediately knew it was Last Guardian. Because I'm like, that's the same fucking kid from Last Guardian demo. Where's the fucking dog? Oh, hi, dog. You're the Last Guardian. Why are they not saying it's the Last Guardian already? I fucking know it's the Last Guardian. Because I still remember that
game. You might have known it was the Last Guardian, but I...
Do you
part of me did not want to believe it.
Good, you're good. You can be one of those people that was like, they're making a Final Fantasy VII movie before they talked about the fucking, before they literally went remake. Just to shut people up.
I was one of the people, because you remember they brought up the Final Fantasy thing. I'm like, oh no, they ain't doing Final Fantasy VII. Are you kidding me? It was just a joke. That's the Final Fantasy they're doing. Then all of a sudden that shows up and it's just like everybody's jaws drop.
It's like, hey, here's World of Final Fantasy. This stupid mobile game bullshit, whatever the fuck this is, I don't care.
Just to make everybody doubt that Final Fantasy VII was actually being remade.
And then,
you know, Sony's a big dick like that.
Yeah, and then at Square Enix, they replayed the teaser. It's just like, hey, Final Fantasy VII's in development. Final Fantasy Remake's in development. Bye. What, you want more? What? But all you want is the remake. What more do you want? Hey,
everyone wants Final Fantasy 7-2 and 7-3.
Yeah, well, they're gonna get the Final Fantasy 7 PC version on iOS and PlayStation 4 this year.
Well, now they need Final Fantasy 7-2.
But then they're gonna get the Final Fantasy 7 remake on PlayStation 4
when they actually get there.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. But then they're gonna get the Final Fantasy 7 remake on PlayStation 4 like 2 years later. So we're going to have two completely different versions of Final Fantasy VII on the same console for God knows what reason. Anyway, as Glock said, we had the Last Guardian debut going, hey, we're coming out next year for realsies this time. We had a full demo. Dog's cute. The boy's speaking gibberish. And apparently the dog's afraid of whatever the fuck was on the tracks.
I think that thing was some kind of a relic. I don't know. The dog was too fearful of it, so something about it.
The dog was about 5 seconds away from flipping the fuck out about that. He's like, no, 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 I ain't going near that. Fuck that.
He acted like he was gonna freaking shoot him. I don't understand.
Yeah, from what I'm reading, IGN's a bit hesitant about the game because it's not clear how scripted the dog is, and it's a dog. As much as they try to mix in other stuff, it's a dog. It acts like a dog. It is a giant dog. With feathers and wings. And horn thingies.
So it's a flying dog?
No, because it can't fly.
It's a gliding dog.
I don't think it can even glide.
I don't know.
Those wings ain't big enough to glide, let alone fly. It can fall with style. But it ain't fucking gliding, son. We had new trailer for Street Fighter V showing off Cammy and new character Birdie, I believe?
Yes.
I think Birdie's a new character. I don't know anything about... I know Cammy's not a new character.
It acted like Cammy was a new character, which kind of confused me.
She's not. She was in the fucking Street Fighter movie.
I know. That's what confused me. I'm sitting here going, wait a minute. Huh? Why is it? What? Cammy's not new.
We got another demo of No Man's Sky, which, yay, space combat and flying cross planets, and I lost interest after a while when I was watching the replay.
Oh, wow.
I was like, I was just thinking, like, fuck, I do not care about No Man's Sky now.
I'm kind of interested. Like, I'd be willing to play it. It seems to me, it looks like the completely randomized world generator like on Minecraft, sort of.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. But with different planets, with different living beings and stuff like that, so the complete randomness adds to it to make it a bigger Minecraft, almost.
I just hope it's got more than just, hey, go explore these places as the thing you should be doing.
Notice that when he was destroying the world, he was gathering resources? So I'm thinking you're actually able to build stuff.
Okay, that's actually worthwhile then, so.
Because when he started destroying the rock and the Sentinels came and tried to kill him, he was gathering resources, because whenever he destroyed part of the rock, resources came to him.
Okay, that's good. I was like, if you're just out here exploring shit, this game ain't lasting. If you can at least try to capture the Minecraft audience attention, then you can get somewhere with this.
Oh god, my battery's dying. I'll be back. I thought I grabbed my charger, but apparently I didn't.
Rock's dying.
Apparently. Alright.
And he has Echo.
Yes. Media Molecule showed off their new IP, which is called Dreams, and it's... It looks pretty.
Don't die on me.
Echo!
Dreams look pretty.
Okay,
I'll be back. I mean, I like the art style, which was like... how to describe it? Water painting, essentially?
Okay.
And you're like creating just like whatever you want, and you're like literally painting with the six-axis controller. And I'm like, that's neat. Yes. Yeah. Miyamoto's new project.
Yeah.
I'm like, it's pretty, and I like the creation stuff, and that's about the long and short of my conversation there.
My thing is, I don't know how well it's gonna work out for just new people. Because, I mean, art isn't necessarily something that everybody can do.
Well, what they were trying to push is, like, you don't have to be good because it's a dream, and it can look like shit. Because in your dream, stuff can look like shit because it's your dream. Which I go, good enough. They're fully admitting the fact that most people will make stuff that looks like shit. I'm okay with that.
That's a double-edged sword there.
I know. But like, if they're at least trying to pitch this as, you don't have to be good at art to really do something with this game, I'm like, okay. You got my argument beat there for the moment.
Until someone decides they want to draw a dick.
To be fair, that would happen no matter what we tried.
Yeah, somebody would find a way.
Yeah.
Firewatch, which I don't know why GameStop has it listed as humorous. I don't think that game's supposed to be humorous.
It's not meant to be humorous. It actually looks pretty legit, in my opinion.
I'm like, someone's already calling
like,
the plot
I'll admit
twist.
One joke. I'll admit that joke was pretty freaking cool, but...
But it's humorous.
And I don't see how... If you're talking about the chick being the bad guy, I don't see it.
No, that's not the plot twist.
What's the plot twist?
The chick doesn't exist. And you're the person that's kidnapping all the people.
Wow. That would be interesting. I'll admit
Well, movie already did it, so it's not that interesting anymore.
Who did it?
Blank Points, I think.
Huh?
Blank Point, I think, was the name of the movie. I'm trying to remember the movie that the Weekly Poll podcast, when they were talking about E3 stuff for the beta podcast of the Weekly Play, which the podcast was them essentially running through, like, they revealed new Halo 5, new details for Halo 5, moving on.
Great.
And I'm like,
wow.
Can you talk about, like, half the stuff you're trying to do? Plus, I think they're trying to do all the press conferences so far in one show in, like, an hour.
Oh, shit.
And I'm like, all right, team. Let me tell you something. One, you ain't fucking doing that because you ain't even going to be able to actually cover and have a conversation about half the shit that's going to happen during these press conferences in an hour. And two, fucking, why don't you just do the top three and just call it a day?
Yeah.
All right, we got reveal of the new Dance of Destiny expansion, The Taken King, which has the daddy of Onyx going, "You fucking kill my son. I'm gonna fucking murder you."
You're fucking dead. Asshole.
Yep.
You're dead, son. You're dead.
And all three classes are getting new specials, I believe. Like, one of the classes is getting a bow and arrow. The rogue is getting force lightning. And the titan is getting Thor's hammer, except it's fire, not lightning this time.
Oh, but the lightning.
But no, because the rogue has force lightning, so we can't do lightning.
But the lightning can spark fire.
No.
You see where I'm going?
But the fire can be light.
But it's not.
We got a bunch of indie titles. I did not pay attention to any of the indie titles, like, because none of them were Cuphead, so I didn't care.
By the way, I was I was really shocked that the entire E3 so far there has been no mention of Quantum Break.
Didn't we say it was not going to show up during the when we were talking about E3 stuff last week, Tommy?
I don't remember, actually.
I want to say we were. Either that or the game is outright canceled at this point because, you know, Microsoft TV is canceled.
Oh, it is?
Yeah, their TV development studio, yeah, that closed down.
Yeah.
Like 6 months ago.
Well, that was quick.
Yep.
Like, the lock stuff was the only thing that got completed.
Uh-huh. Like, yeah, Halo Outfall was, like, the first and last project from them.
I don't understand why, because, I mean, it was actually pretty... It was a good show.
It wasn't Nightfall, it was the fact that they were losing money.
Yeah.
And it's like, well, this thing's not making money. Tank. We're hitting that eject button. We're getting out of here. We're getting out of the TV game now. Now we understand why Square Enix dumped their movie division after their first Final Fantasy movie.
That wasn't their first Final Fantasy movie. They've made a couple, actually.
Spirits Within was their first Final Fantasy movie.
No, because they made Final Fantasy VII Advent Children.
Do you not understand why I said first? I didn't say their only Final Fantasy movie. I said their first Final Fantasy movie.
If they would have dumped it, then they wouldn't have made the second movie.
I said Square Enix's movie division.
Final Fantasy VII Advent Children was their movie division.
Really? I thought that movie division was immediately closed down after Spirits Within. And Advent Children was done by somebody else.
Because
I think Spirits Within bombed hard and literally sank that entire division of Square Enix.
Directed by Tetsuya Nomura, written by Kazushige Nojima. Developed by Visual Works and Square Enix.
Yeah, that does not mean their movie division. Their movie division was not involved with Advent Children.
Okay.
Anyway, Assassin's Creed.
I'm sorry, I was mistaken then.
I figured, like, Square Enix Pictures, I believe was the name of it, got tanked immediately after Spirits Within came out, because Spirits Within bombed. So I'm like, Advent Children came out, like, 5 years after that? It came out, like, a long time after Spirits Within. And it's funny, the Game Theory, like, references that as the highest-rated video game movie, apparently, according to their film theory. Or at least according to Rotten Tomatoes, that is the highest rated video game movie. Which I'm like, no. That can't be. There is no fucking way that that is the highest rated movie. That can't be the best video game movie according to Rotten Tomatoes.
Sure it can.
Assassin's Creed Syndicate showed off Evie Fry, and why is she the more badass twin than Jacob?
Because she's the master assassin, he's not.
Why is she not the main character of this game?
Because if you play them, because it's the same thing they did with the first Assassin's Creed with Altair being the master assassin. They had to downgrade him before you could actually play him and actually get through the campaign. So it's going to be easier to start you off with the less successful brother than the more successful sister, because if she's the master assassin, she's going to have all her tools at her belt already, and you don't need that at the beginning of the game. You need level progression.
Except you can swap them out at any time, at any point in the game, and you're only locked to one of them during certain story missions.
I didn't know that. I'm sorry.
I'm like, why is Evie still not the main character of this game? She's far better than her fucking brother.
Possibly because since you're going to be locked to him more often, I guess you need to kind of learn. It might be because of the whole Helix thing, because did you notice it was actually Helix that was doing it?
Yeah, it was like Helix 4.0.
Yeah, so it might be because of the Helix programming.
Fantastic. Batman Arkham Knight showing off the first moments of the upcoming open world game. Except I don't think it did, because that was the Scarecrow, that was a trailer for the Scarecrow DLC.
Well, then
it still looked legit.
Was the first moments of the Scarecrow DLC.
Yeah, because they immediately fucking shield the Scarecrow DLC. Yeah, that looked cool. I'm just like, that's not the opening moments of the game. That's the opening moments of the Scarecrow DLC that's exclusive to PlayStation 4 at the Sony press conference. We got to look at some Black Ops co-op gameplay and the confirmation that PlayStation 4 users will be getting the Call of Duty Black Ops DLC first on PlayStation 4 and first access to an open beta.
So basically Sony said, yeah, remember that deal that Microsoft always had? We got it.
Yeah. Also, how the fuck is Shuriken Sentai out before Drive?
It usually is, ain't it?
No.
No, it's Garo that's usually out.
Yeah, well, that's because Garo comes out like 2 days before Shuriken Sentai and Drive. Which, by the way, Drive's still not out. That's a problem! And I have an R&R due tomorrow! Well, I can't ride the R&R because no one subs for it yet.
TV Nihon hasn't either?
No, theirs don't come out until Thursday, normally.
Oh, shit.
Yeah, those don't come out until after I've already posted the R&R.
So, basically, we're at the point of, if they don't come out by the time we finish this, there might not be an R&R this week.
No, there might not be an R&R if they're not out by the time we start streaming tomorrow.
True. And if they're not out by the time we start streaming Thursday...
Well, start recording Thursday.
Well, whatever. Then that'll be an even bigger trick.
Yeah.
Because I didn't get to catch all the Raw. So we can't even try to wing it.
Yeah.
Great.
Black Ops looked like Black Ops, so.
I say again, it looked like Titanfall.
Or did it look like Advanced Warfare?
It looked more like Titanfall.
A mix of both, honestly, because I still felt like, oh, this feels like a Call of Duty game.
That's because Titanfall felt like a Call of Duty game, but with Titans.
Well, that's because it's made by the Call of Duty people. So in a roundabout way, it's still a Call of Duty game.
It just didn't hold the fishy name.
Yeah, nope. It decided to get ripped off by Garden Warfare 2. We had Disney Infinity 3.0 take center stage for Star Wars stuff. And the Boba Fett figure got revealed, and I don't fucking care.
That's kind of weird that they took to Sony for Infinity.
I don't know. I guess it's because Nintendo had Skylanders. Spoiler, Skylanders was at Nintendo, and it was actually kind of good.
Yeah, but I don't know. It kind of seems weird to me for Infinity to be at Sony.
Yeah. We got the debut of one of the only single-player modes of the game, which is Survival Mode, which is a two-player co-op horde mode where you survive 15 waves of enemies.
Oh, that might be interesting.
Yeah, kind of. You've got a pool of lives. I mean, it looked kind of good, but I'm like, this is not what Battlefront needs. Not really. I don't need another horde mode in my first-person online shooters. Horde mode, I think it's overdone a lot. Then we had the Naughty Dog demo that fucked up first. And they had to restart the demo. And I laughed my ass off because that's the second time an Uncharted 4 demo's fucked up on a live stage.
Yep.
But, God, does it look fantastic. I love the banter between Drake and Sully the entire time. Sully's just like, we just gotta go down. It's like, oh, we gotta get there. Just go downhill. It's like, all right, I'll just go downhill and just hit everything along the way, apparently. And try to lose that truck, but we keep finding it because that truck is a son of a bitch and won't leave us the fuck alone.
Yeah, pretty much.
But yeah, Uncharted 4 is great. Guerrilla Games, makers of Killzone, showed off Horizon Zero Dawn, which looked good. I liked it outside of the weird ass fucking concept.
I love the freaking Tyrannosaurus robot nutshot at the very beginning of it. It's just like, oh my god!
I think you mentioned that yesterday, actually.
Yeah. Like, how to describe this? You play as a character that apparently is a part of one of several tribes that exist in the world after an apocalypse that took out a world like ours, essentially.
Yeah.
And now there are robot creatures that you hunt for materials.
Which they still haven't explained why.
Well, they even said in the trailer, it's like, we don't know why. They just exist. And I'm like, what the fuck? You need to explain this, because it's the weirdest concept of the fucking world.
Wait. So, they didn't even know?
Yes. They don't know about the old world. They're just like, the old world existed, and we don't know why they're gone, and we don't know what this shit is. And we try to balance technology and nature to have this whole green life bullshit message. Because that's what I thought initially. It's like, oh my god, this green life bullshit message needs to fuck off a cliff. We get it. We're assholes to the planet. Thank you. We know.
I love how you... You're just, like, completely blowing them off. Like, yeah, uh-huh, shut up.
I like the game. I like the gameplay. But fuck your Greenpeace message. Look, we are assholes to the planet. We know.
But do we know enough?
We know enough. We know we fucked the planet a bit. It's because we live and we exist on the scale we do. That's going to happen.
Hey.
There's no easy way to be at one with nature unless you decide to give up everything that makes us, you know, life as it is. All right. We got a fucking CGI trailer, CGI trailer for fucking Hitman, and I don't care, because I'm tired of CGI trailers.
Yeah, that is kind of getting annoying.
Look, you still have the CGI trailer. I don't care. Immediately. And I'm like, ooh, a new Hitman. And apparently there's a new movie coming. And I'm like, I don't care. And it's not exclusive onto the PlayStation 4. Woo. World of Final Fantasy looks like a game that I don't care about. Well, it's like chibi-style characters, and you're focusing on this brother and sister that are apparently visiting this world, and then there's the heroes of Final Fantasy, apparently, so it's Decade, except I don't care.
Jesus, way to just blow it off.
I've seen it twice.
Die.
I've seen it twice, and I don't care. And it's not a mobile title, because it's coming from PlayStation 4 and PlayStation Vita, and I'm like... Also, you showed, like, no gameplay of this game, so again, I don't care.
CGI trailers for days.
No, it's not a CGI trailer. It's an actual in-game trailer, but no gameplay.
So, cutscene.
Yep. Yeah. All cutscenes.
Gets back to the equivalent to CGI in my book.
Yep.
It's like, I don't care what the freaking cutscenes look like. I don't know what the game looks like.
Hey, I'm doing a movie CGI right now.
Oh, fantastic.
I'm doing a contract right now.
By the way, folks, PC gaming show's going on right now. If you're bored of that bullshit, you can watch us.
Yeah, because, you know...
We're not AMD talking about graphics cards.
For 20 minutes. Yes, they talked. I think they talked about it for 20 minutes.
I had to say it.
Hell,
and when did E3 turn into CES?
I don't know. Take that bullshit to CES so I don't care.
CES?
Consumer Electronics Show. Essentially, think E3 except
definitely.
All of the, like, tech companies bring all their prototype shit and all that stuff.
I knew what it was, I just it didn't register for some reason.
Hell literally freezes over as Square Enix announces, by the way, we're making Final Fantasy VII because you people won't shut up about it. So here, take it, but we're gonna shove the fucking PC version in your face on the PlayStation 4 and iOS later this year, because we gotta get that to sell a few more copies, because apparently that will fund the Final Fantasy VII remake.
Yes, because everyone heard me yesterday. When I thought that they had just trolled everyone with the other Final Fantasy game that we just told you about.
Yeah.
With World of Final Fantasy VIII, I mean, 7. When I made that comment.
Oh. Yes, that. I legit thought that they had just trolled everyone and said, no, here's your Final Fantasy game. And then they do that, and it's just like, oh my god. And everyone in the entire house, their jaws drop.
Yeah. Top of that, Shenmue 3 got announced as a Kickstarter project from the original team, and it was funded like fucking like 8 o'clock this morning.
Yeah, and my jaw dropped when I saw that.
Yeah, I think it was one of the quicker Kickstarter fundings.
I believe it is the fastest Kickstarter funded project to date.
That's what I was thinking. I saw
it was funded in less than 24 hours. I think that officially makes it the fastest Kickstarter project. Hell, it broke Kickstarter.
Yeah, it did. It legit broke Kickstarter.
Okay, let's be serious here. This E3 has been the E3 of breaking websites.
But here's the thing. Nothing has broke Kickstarter yet, as far as I know. Mighty No. 9 didn't break Kickstarter. Ukulele didn't break Kickstarter. Bloodstained didn't break Kickstarter. But this fucking broke it!
Yeah. And you want to know the thing that is common with all three of those?
They weren't announced at an E3 press conference.
Number one. Number two, they weren't funded as quick as this.
True. And they also aren't actual fucking sequels to an old game. This is an actual sequel to Shenmue 2.
It's one of those that... All three of those were new games, essentially. And all three of those were funded over a course of a larger period than this one. And like you said, none of them were mentioned in an E3.
Yeah, we literally had a countdown at the press conference to be like, 3, 2, 1, Kickstarter's live. And then I'm sure like half that crowd were like, get on that! Money! Money! I literally can't shove my money into my phone, but if I did, I would. And they are halfway through their stretch goals right now. They have about 2.8 million. Which, here's the stretch goals. Shenmue 1 and 2 cinema shorts. Essentially, movie versions of Shenmue 7, 1 and 2. Blech, I can't speak. Dutch subtitles, French subtitles, and Spanish subtitles, Italian subtitles, a rapport system, a skill tree system, and then Baisha Village expanded plus minigames times 5 at 4 million.
I do want to make this a little bit known of what I know has broke the C3.
The eShop?
The eShop was the first victim.
Mm-hmm. Twitch, twice.
Twitch.
Twice.
Which Twitch is normal.
The Twitch happened all day. It wasn't just twice.
Oh, it was only twice for me.
Oh, Twitch no, it is was normal all for breaking. Day for everybody else. Oh. It was just breaking left and right.
I'm gonna count like half of the Nintendo World Championships in that break, mostly because of the ineptitude of the editing at times.
I'm just gonna stick with websites, not with actual programs.
And but, then, okay. Not gigantic.
Battle Cry.
That broke.
It broke.
Just about every beta.
The second it was announced, everyone hopped on it, and it was just...
Xbox Live for both 360 and Xbox One.
Really?
Yeah, I saw where that one was a thing.
Fantastic.
Kickstarter. I think at this point it would be a shorter list of... What was announced at E3 that didn't break?
Yeah.
And with that being said, I would have to think that PSN would probably be the only thing.
Yeah, PSN hasn't broke yet.
Shockingly.
Yet.
If there's a will, there's a way.
Yeah. There was more details on PlayStation View, which I don't fucking care, so we're moving on. And I think they shield the shield Morpheus a bit.
Yeah.
All right. For the two of us, they have to watch the press conference. What'd you think?
Which conference?
Sony's.
I was overall okay. It had the big bang in the beginning, but near the end, it was just dead. I honestly was bored of it by the end. They literally blew their load early.
Wow, Glock.
I had to steal Jeremy's thing for a minute. They blew their load early because everything that was big that everybody wanted, they released right then and there. And then had the rest of it.
Honestly, that's one thing I feel like, as far as what I saw with Bethesda, they did right, and same with Ubisoft. They kind of had that big surprise at the end.
Yeah.
Yeah, yeah.
By the way, Nintendo didn't have that. They actually actively got people to hate on the to direct for a reason, and we'll get to that. It's Metroid related.
At one.
Yeah.
Uh huh.
Yeah.
Yeah. Apparently, that dislike bar is super hard right now on that video, and I'm like, I'm not surprised. See, yeah. When Nintendo derps, they derp hard.
Oh, yeah, it was hard.
I'll say this. Bethesda probably has the tightest and probably the best conference, but has the biggest surprises and the biggest moments from a press conference this year.
It was still dead for me, though, at the end. I still... say that they didn't set it up right. They had everything they needed. They just set it up horrible.
They should
have ended with the Final Fantasy VII.
Yeah, they should literally have been like, hey, we got one more surprise for you. Leave, have that play, and just literally be like, that's the end of the press conference, and just drop the mic there. Just be like, yo.
That is exactly what I thought of when I watched it, although... I don't know. It would have either been Final Fantasy VII or The Last Guardian that they should have done.
No, they should have opened with Last Guardian and ended with Final Fantasy VII. Therefore, it books in with things people keep asking about. We're like, here, take it. Here, seven interfaces so you can stop barking at us.
And then end with Final Fantasy VII to make everyone's jaws drop as they leave. That, yes, I agree. That would have been perfect for them.
All right, let's talk about the Nintendo Digital event then. That was about an hour long and fantastic. I love how the fucking... God damn it. Come on.
What happened?
Apparently when I transition scenes on OBS, it doesn't like to keep the Firefox window.
Good one.
I can't help it. It doesn't exist, apparently. So... excuse me while I redo it again. I'll have to do it again every single time we transition. So, Nintendo Digital Event. How is everyone feeling about that one off the bat?
I didn't really watch it. I was sleeping.
not the only one who watched the whole thing.
Yeah.
Fantastic.
I was sleeping. I was enjoying my sleep because I got up really early yesterday just to watch everything.
All right. That's fantastic.
From what I looked up of it, honestly, I was kind of like, meh. Because I didn't feel like it was as strong as it could have been.
Well, I think that's because, one, Smash Direct yesterday, Sunday. Two, they have Nintendo Directs all the time, so we kind of blow our load on a lot of that stuff ahead of time. And three, yeah. DNX comes out next year, and someone said $10 Legend of Zelda is a launch title for NX. And I'm like, probably.
I don't know. I almost disagree with NX being out next year. Because they said we wouldn't see it until next year.
Right.
That doesn't necessarily mean that it will be released next year.
Right, but the new Legend of Zelda is going to be a launch title for it, which is why they weren't going to talk about Legend of Zelda this year.
I don't know.
I'm just going to throw this in because they just screwed up hard on PC Gamer.
What'd they do?
The guy's mic is muted and he's been talking this entire time.
Bravo, fantastic. Ladies and gentlemen, this is why we can call ourselves professional. Because they can fuck up just as hard as we can.
Not worse. Because all of our audio is going through, correct?
Yes.
Yeah.
Well then, yeah, at least we're better than them.
Alright, so, right off the bat, Star Fox Zero, it looked great. Apparently it's not a reboot, even though it looks exactly like a reboot.
No, it's not a reboot, it's a reimagining.
Yeah, that's their bullshit fucking term for it. It's a fucking reboot.
It's a reboot.
It's a reboot. Don't fucking kid yourselves. It's a reboot. It is.
No.
No,
you know what it is?
Reimagining.
No, you know what it is. It's not a reboot. This is a fancier prequel to Star Fox 64 because it actually uses stuff that didn't exist. Well, that existed in a game that never got released.
Or it's a remake of Star Fox 2. Except we're taking out those two other characters that are in Star Fox 2 and we're adding other stuff besides the Walker. Which, by the way, the Walker from Star Fox 2 is in the game and I friggin' love it, because you can just transform between Flyer and Walker in the all-range mode stages. Just ooh. Like, boop, transform, boop, now I'm flying. Also, you can use the gamepad, and the screen for the gamepad is in first person. You can use that to aim and shoot.
Hmm.
Oh. Essentially, if your plane is pointed straight, and everything you see in that field of view, you can just look around and shoot with the gamepad. I don't know if I'll use that, but that's a kind of a neat idea. But yeah, it looked great, and it was a Corneria stage, and you had all the normal dialogue. And literally the start of the stages are now, like, you have the team and the Great Fox, like, orbiting the planet, and then you do, like, the check-in for everyone, and then you literally, like, go up and then, like, boost down to the planet. So you get, like, the re-entry, like, the fiery re-entry, and it fades to white, and then you cut back into gameplay.
Wait, what are we talking about again? Sorry, I zoned out.
Star Fox Zero.
Yeah, how was that?
It's fantastic.
You started to say Star Fox 64, didn't you?
It pretty much is Star Fox 64, the third, or the fourth, depending on how you want to take that 3DS remake.
It was just a... It was the same game, wasn't it? Nothing changed game-wise, right?
You have the addition of the Walker. There's a brand new boss. There are brand new bosses, and there's brand new enemies.
So it was different.
Yeah, and the stage is also laid out a bit differently in parts. Like, some stuff is like, yeah, this is obvious, like, Corn Area from 64. But other parts are like, this isn't Corn Area. Like, Falco's is like, we're gonna go take the back road. And I'm like, that's not how you did that before. And then you end up fighting a different boss than if you did take that shortcut with Falco.
Huh.
And you're, like, fighting Pigma in a completely different stage.
Hmm.
So I'm like, it's obviously it's a reboot that's taking information from Star Fox 64, but is doing its own things in the process as well. But it still looked great. And it's being done by Platinum Games. Although some of the textures did look a little bad when I saw some up-close screenshots.
I'm sure it's an E3 demo.
Yeah, but like in motion, I didn't notice it, but it took like still image screenshots close to the ground to make me go, oh yeah, those textures are a bit like low. That makes the game look not as good. Hyrule Warriors is coming to the 3DS, which we talked about Friday because it leaked Thursday.
Yeah.
And it was pretty much all the same information we found out then. So, no confirmation of Link L yet. I'm sure
that's Linkle.
I'm going to go Link L because that sounds better.
I'm going with Linkle. Because it sounds funnier.
Fire Emblem Myth is coming to the States as Fire Emblem Fates. And we got a trailer in English with some new stuff in there that was cool. And they still confirmed it's coming as two versions, which is fine. I'll buy the white version. I'll pick up the black version as DLC at some point later on down the line. Because I want to play the white story first before the black story.
So I have to ask, are you still going to call it Fire Emblem Myth?
Oh, I'm still going to call it Fire. It's stupid fucking subtitle in Japan. Well, they even changed the name of the versions because now it's, I think, Birthright and Conqueror.
Huh.
I assume Birthright is white and Conqueror is black. SNT Crossfire Emblem got a new Japanese trailer, which confirmed that essentially it's treating like the Fire Emblem characters as personas, and I'm like, I'm okay with this! I know ProJer was like, oh, I don't care about this game because it's not for me. And I'm like, this is so for me as a Persona fan.
And as a Fire Emblem fan.
Yes, I know. I think like someone is on Square Attack is like, fuck that game because that's an insult to SMT and Fire Emblem fans. And I'm like, you, sir, will have no fun with this game. I will have fun with this game. I like what they're doing with that.
Square Attack threw freaking Garden Warfare in the trash. Honestly, at this point,
It was commenters on Square Attack's forum, Square Attack's article about the Nintendo Direct, so.
Oh, okay. I was about to say, Screw Attack, you know what, just screw Attack, because they're the ones that were freaking...
Garden Warfare 2 in the trash?
Yeah.
Xenoblade Chronicles X get a release date, December 5th, 2015, so yay, not a game in November! Woo! Everyone's wallet can breathe a sigh of relief.
Except for that's also during the holiday rush still, so...
That ain't helping.
No one's wallet can breathe.
Animal Crossing Happy Home Designer got a new trailer. So, yay. I don't know. I don't care about Happy Home Designer. I also don't care about the Amiibo cards. we got some more Woolly World stuff. We also talked about the Amiibo support that we already knew about. And we got a release date for Super Mario Maker coming out September 11, 2015. And it confirmed a new feature, the Mystery Mushroom, which allows you to transform into a variety of characters that are all tied to Amiibos. I believe it's Marth, Wii Fit Trainer, Isabelle, Link, and somebody else. But if you tap the Amiibo, you can transform into that character. The Wii Fit Trainer, I believe, is annoying because every time you jump, she says up. And every time you go down, she says down.
Wow.
And I'm like, no. No. If Wii Fit Trainer is this, I will literally murder someone.
Well, then get ready to murder someone.
Because I saw Game Explain stand mode. I'm like, no. Why? The Four Swords is getting a spiritual sequel in the form of Legend of Zelda Triforce Heroes, which is pretty much running on the same Link to the Link Between Worlds engine stuff, and it is a online co-op game between three friends that are playing three Links, and you're solving puzzles and exploring dungeons. Essentially,
so Four Swords Adventures Online.
Yep, and you're actually exploring dungeons, which I don't think you did in Four Swords, and you're actually solving puzzles as a team, and they have this totem mechanic where essentially you stack on top of each other and attacks things.
Really?
Yes. We might need it to reach the high weak point on an enemy.
Hmm.
Then we got the thing that pissed everyone right the fuck off. Metroid Prime Federation Force was announced for 3DS. Hey Glock, you remember that soccer game from the World Championships?
You're freaking kidding
me. It was that.
Nope, it's more than that. That's just the sports component of it. There's also four-player co-op adventure where you play as generic Federation Force goons in the Metroid Prime universe.
Oh my
god. Coming 2016, who's excited?
Oh my god. They can go right to hell.
I want a Metroid Prime 4.
But you wanted a Metroid Prime game, right?
I want a Metroid Prime 4.
But this is Metroid Prime 4.
No, it isn't.
Yes, it is.
This is Metroid Prime. We're screwing the series up.
To be fair, Other M did that long before we got here.
I'm talking about the Metroid Prime series, not the Metroid series.
But it's all the same timeline, so it still counts.
No, it doesn't still count. Sorry.
Yes, it does.
No, it doesn't.
Yes, it does.
No, it doesn't.
Anyway. We're getting essentially Animal Crossing Mario Party called Animal Crossing Amiibo Festival. And it has all sorts of Animal Crossing Amiibos. And I'm officially saying nope on the Animal Crossing Amiibos now.
Why?
Because nope. I'm not falling into this trap. Because A, I'm not a fan of Animal Crossing. B, I don't care for your Mario Party knockoff game. And C, I'm not a fan of Animal Crossing, so I don't care about your Amiibos. Yeah, and it also will require Amiibo to play. And by Amiibo, I mean the Animal Crossing Amiibos.
I'm probably gonna have to agree with you on that one.
Yeah.
Not falling into that trap.
Yeah. Yeah. What's the other one I care about? Villager. Because he's a Smash fighter. So, moving on. Yo-Kai Watch got an English trailer because apparently that's a huge franchise in Japan.
Yeah.
So, we're getting it stateside. I decided to sit down and, watch the first episode of the anime, and I did not watch the second episode. I'm like, this is a thing. I don't care. Moving on. Something I actually do care about, a Mario RPG crossover, where we're taking the Mario Luigi series of RPGs and the Paper Mario RPGs and combining them into one game.
Ooh.
Essentially, take like all of the mechanics of the Mario and Luigi games and add in Paper Mario as a third-party member. And add in all the characters from Mario, from the Paper Mario, meeting their counterparts from the Mario Luigi series. And it, like, I assume hilarity ensues. Because you have, like, Paper Mario staring down Mario Luigi Bowser. Or, like, Paper Bowser staring down Mario Luigi Bowser. Paper Peach talking to Mario Luigi Peach. And it is those actual characters. Like, the white outline and everything. That is how they're represented in the game. I don't think there's, like, I think it's, like, technically a 3D model, maybe, but it's still, like, the paper character. We're getting a new Mario Tennis for Wii U, and it's called Mario Tennis Ultra Smash. And they put in the giant mushroom in there, and I'm like, it's Mario Tennis, I'm sold. Like, I'm just like, I'm in, I don't need to know anymore. It's Mario Tennis. I'm happy.
Is that something we're going to have to both get?
Maybe, because it is 2v2.
I'm sure there is 1v1, too.
Not sure. Finally!
If only I had a Wii U, I'm actually tempted to get one.
You should.
The best next-gen console right now.
Smash,
I don't know.
Mario Kart 8, Hyrule Warriors.
Splatoon.
I'm still iffy about it. Like,
so much virtual console stuff that you don't know right offhand, but would love if you actually got your hands on it.
Mm-hmm.
I'm not trying to push Nintendo because, quite frankly, I feel like they kind of biffed this E3.
Don't worry, they'll show everybody up next year.
Yeah, they did last year, so I gotta give them credit there.
Yep. Finally, you remember when I mentioned to you that Skylanders might have amiibo compatibility?
Yeah, I saw this, actually.
Well, it's not quite what you thought. Essentially, Donkey Kong and Bowser are going to have Skylanders versions of those characters. And they're going to have their own special vehicle.
And apparently, each one's going to have different bases to be used as an amiibo or a Skylander.
It's not different bases. Essentially, you just twist the base and all, and it goes from Skylander compatibility to amiibo compatibility. That's really it.
That will be
how in the world that actually functionally works, considering what we know about those of how amiibos work. I don't know, because it's just a chip. Like, how does twisting the base work?
Possibly because I'm wondering if maybe since they both are NFC based, if like Skylanders is more of a complex base, whereas the amiibos are more of a simplistic. So in a sense, you're turning both the NFC chip, like it's two chips. Turned one way, it's the complex for the Skylander. Turned the other way, they line up, and it's the simple for the amiibo.
Yep.
That's the only thing I can think of.
What?
I'm playing the game, and I'm trying to figure out what this company is supposed to be. Nippon creating the Playdion, and it's not Sony because Sony's on here.
Playdion, I don't know.
It's a pink or a purple console. It looks kind of like a Sony. It looks kind of like a PlayStation, but with a Nintendo controller.
Oh, it might be the theoretical Sony Nintendo console.
That's possible.
Also, Diddy Kong guest stars because he's like in the like sidecar on Donkey Kong's vehicle. Bowser has a plane. Donkey Kong has like a tank. And also he has two halves of a barrel as boxing gloves. And Bowser can, like, become Magma Bowser and, like, set Koopa Troopas on fire to turn them into dry bones and send them after people. And he's got armor and a hammer. And the Skylanders look cool. And that's a neat idea. And hopefully they'll do more with it. Because you know who should also be put in there with a really cool redesign?
Who?
Samus, just to show up Nintendo that, hey, we can do Metroid better.
Yes. Yes. Yes.
Kind of messed up, but okay.
Alright. Well, to prevent me from having to redo the screen region every single time, you're going to be taking a look at the list of articles as I open them up.
What?
I can't. I have to redo the screen region every time I transition, so I'm not going to...
That's why I put the title card as a checkbox toggle.
Why didn't I think of that?
That way I just toggle that and hide it while I'm opening the others up.
Oh!
I technically only use one.
They're talking about that game with that blind chick.
TGS.
Oh, the indie game that was at Xbox, the Microsoft press conference?
Yeah.
Alright. Well, honestly, Nintendo did all right at best. It wasn't like the best showing Nintendo could do, but it had stuff I was interested in, so it's a win-win for me, at least.
Don't get me wrong, I don't feel like they screwed up.
Yeah.
They just could have done better.
Right. Like, in all honesty, even if they'd kept half of the Smash stuff back and waited until now, yeah, it was already leaked.
Yeah.
We already knew about it, but still,
the release itself
like
would have shocked
done,
people.
I feel like that would have done more. But I don't know. I guess really with their press conference, whatever the hell they're calling it
digital
now,
event.
It's still considered a press conference, though. Yeah. That's what's bad. But basically with that one, I guess you kind of do have to count the whole Smash info dump that we got Sunday in a sense, because that was part of E3. So I kind of feel like that should be counted in with it at least.
Yeah.
Even though it was separate. But all together, I think Nintendo did all right. But yeah, that digital event could have went a little better.
Yeah. So, let's talk about Square Enix.
Oh, great.
I know the guy with the fucking near smiling face has become a meme at this point. It's up on stream for those wondering. We got Just Cause 3 coming this December, and it looked like a Just Cause game. I don't have interest in Just Cause, so I'm like the last person to say anything about that. We're getting a new Nier, or as people called it, Nier, because the subtitle was a jumbled mess of letters and symbols, because they haven't decided on the subtitle yet. Also, Platinum Games is attached to that, so Platinum Games is like expanding hard out of nowhere. But it looked cool, I guess. I have no experience with Nier, so. Just like how we got the Hitman mobile game, we're getting a Lara Croft Go game. Yay. I don't care. As I predicted, Kingdom Hearts Key is coming to America as Kingdom Hearts Key Unchained. So, yay, we get the browser game that got turned into a mobile game that's now a mobile game over here. Woo. I'm probably
I like the title for the next one. Oh god.
Yeah. Literally the less exciting Final Fantasy VII is coming to PS4 is coming to PS4 like later this year. And iOS.
Question is it going to be console exclusive?
Probably.
I would assume. Glock. I hope not.
Glock.
I truly do.
Glock.
You can get
Final
it on PC.
Final Fantasy was PS for the longest.
Glock. I know, Glock. But I seriously...
Glock. This
I
same...
want to play it!
It's on PC, you nitwit!
Yes, it's on PC.
Yeah.
I don't have a powerful computer.
It's not.
So buy it on Steam, and then when you get a better computer, then you can still play it.
Like, I won't be able to buy a better computer until far into college.
So about to take a look. I don't think that's graphically intensive. It's a PlayStation 1 era game.
It's going to be remade. As in, it's going to be completely redone. Oh. As in, to be with today's graphics.
Oh, I thought we were talking about the less exciting Final Fantasy VII on PC.
Oh, no.
Okay. So let's say, Glock, you can still play Final Fantasy VII. You just can't play the pretty version of it. You can play the less pretty, more nostalgic version of Final Fantasy VII.
What I want to play is I want them to remake Crisis Core. Even though it doesn't really need to be remade, I still want to see it remade because Crisis Core was freaking amazing.
Well, Glock, here's what's going to happen. If Final Fantasy VII sells well enough, they'll remake Dirge of Cerberus, and then they'll remake Crisis Core.
Maybe.
I didn't really care for Dirge of Cerberus, to be honest.
Well, that's technically, like, where, if they're going to continue the story of Final Fantasy VII, where they pick up from.
Yeah.
And plus, there's a decade connection to it.
What?
Yeah, there's a decade connection to the Dirge of Cerberus.
Repeat that.
There's a decade connection to the Dirge of Cerberus.
What do you mean, decade?
You know the guy who sings the main theme for Decade?
Yeah.
You know one of the main villains of Dirge of Cerberus?
Oh, son of a whore.
They're the same person.
Oh, God.
Gackt is a main villain of Final Fantasy Dirge of Cerberus. Literally his face in everything. I just ruined Dirge of Cerberus a little more for you, didn't I?
Yeah, you did.
Well, my day's complete. Moving on. We got Kingdom Hearts 3. We got a Kingdom Hearts 3 gameplay demo, and I was like, fuck yeah. And by demo, I meant trailer. That totally is a bit fake because the HUD doesn't work. Because if you watch it, the command menu doesn't move. And Sora's MP bar never goes down, and his health only goes down rarely. And if it does, it mostly happens between cuts. Although Goofy and Donald's health bar will go down. So that means the HUD's working for the most partially.
Hmm.
But yeah, it looked fantastic. We got more of the whole, like, Keyblade turning into different weapons attacks. We got the friggin' theme park ride attacks. It's fucking fantastic. And we had a Xehanort Eriquis conversation that may have revealed, or at least hinted at, who the 13 Bearers of Darkness and possibly the 7 Bearers of Light are. If you're caught up on Kingdom Hearts, you know what I mean. If not, go watch Game Trailer's Kingdom Hearts timeline thing, and then you'll understand what I said.
I need to go through Kingdom Hearts altogether. I'm gonna get emulators, and I'm just gonna go through everything.
Sorry, with Birth by Sleep, because that's canonically the first one.
Is it really?
Yes.
Okay.
Technically, canonically, Key's the first one, but don't worry about Key. That's only important when you're through everything. And I already know how it's important. It's Xehanort. It's always Xehanort. More World of Final Fantasy nonsense that I don't care about. More Hitman CG trailer stuff. I think it showed off some gameplay in a trailer, but that was, like, it. We're getting a Final Fantasy Portal app. I don't know.
Really?
Yes. And we got Deus Ex Mankind Divided gameplay footage, which looked pretty good. So, yay! Alright, so, I'll be honest. Fucking Square Enix was boring as shit.
Sounds like it.
It was.
Because it was like, talk for 10 minutes, and then we finally get the fucking trailer. Fucking... the Just Cause 3 one went for like 10 minutes on a, just monologuing over gameplay footage, and I'm like, fuck off!
It feels to me like Square also didn't really have a lot going for it. Like for the most part, their stuff was already announced elsewhere. So I kind of feel like that's one of those where that you can clearly tell it's because they went last.
Yeah. It's like Kingdom Hearts 3 was my highlight and my only highlight, because I'm like, I either don't know your franchise or don't care. Oh, I forgot to mention New Star Ocean, and I'm like, I don't care because I don't know Star Ocean, and it looks all right, I guess. I don't know. I just got nothing. Like, I only cared about Kingdom Hearts 3 out of Square Enix, and I'm like, you got nothing else for me. And then your nothing Kingdom Hearts 3 focused fucking live show you did on your YouTube was a fucking waste of my time. Because you told me everything I already fucking knew. Literally everything I fucking knew.
You know, what's funny? Almost every year, it boils down to either Square or EA having the press conference.
Mm-hmm.
Like, it always boils down to them, too. I don't get it.
Well, yeah,
Ooh, hang on. What is this?
What in the butt?
They brought a game that actually looks interesting. Hold up.
Oh, God.
Finally?
Finally.
After 2 hours of bullshit?
Uh-huh.
Oh, God, shit's fixing to get real.
Oh, it's a creepy game. Oh, what's going on?
Shit's fixing to get real, and then breaking out that it's a Windows 10 exclusive.
What was that?
What the butt?
Soma.
Soma? Oh, I know Soma. I've heard about Soma.
That looked freaking weird. What
was
that?
Was I right on the Windows 10 exclusive thing?
No. Done? Steam and Sony. PS4.
Oh, wow. Shit.
Well, I found out something else. If I uncheck Firefox, it also does that too.
I didn't say uncheck Firefox, though.
You didn't tell me. That's... See, this is what happens when you put me in charge of streaming for TGS.
Uh-huh.
I fuck it up. Terribly.
I need to get me a computer that I can focus solely on rendering and uploading and editing and all that fun stuff. That way then, my laptop can focus on streaming.
No, what we need is our own editor.
I like editing, though.
We need an editor that knows exactly how to do things, like, really, really, really professionally. And I'm not trying to say anything to you, it's just, it'd be easier for us, because then we can focus on the show itself.
But you do realize that if I think about it when I'm editing this one, because, by the way, the RAW that I'm going to have you put up is not going to be the one that's actually going up. I will purposely find someone giving a middle finger, and it's going to be pointed to you, Glock.
What did I do?
The comment.
What comment?
Have you not seen the Super Mario episode that came out today? Because,
no.
Quite frankly, I am impressed with what I found out I could do with Premiere.
I haven't been able to watch any of our. I haven't been able to watch any of our episodes except for this week. And this week, I've been focused solely on E3.
Oh
well.
Well, go watch us dig around with Super Mario sometime. All right.
Yeah, seriously. I'm trying to think of a good way you could do it, actually, now. Oh, well. Anyhow. Question.
What?
Is the last two articles anything pertaining to press conferences?
Nope.
Then I'm almost tempted to say we do our usual thoughts on... Well, we can't.
No
PC show.
Can we just agree to throw that one out the fucking window now? Because from what I'm hearing, it's a whole lot of bullshit.
It really is.
Fine.
Let's just throw that one out. So let's say... Alright. Alright. So we had Nintendo, Microsoft, Sony as the big three. We had EA, Ubisoft, Square Enix, and Bethesda as the independent four. I don't know what else to name them. So let's start with the independent four. I'm sure the answer's obvious, but who was the best of the independent four?
I'm letting you two go first because I think I've voiced my opinion on this one enough.
On what one?
Oh my god.
Best of the independent four.
The independent four?
Bethesda, Square Enix, Ubisoft, EA.
I thought we've all showcased what we thought was the best. I thought that was obvious.
Well, let's say anyway. 3, 2, 1, go Bethesda.
Bethesda.
Bethesda. Tied to show of E3. Didn't have much bullshit. Most we had was what, ESO and ESO fucking or ES trading card game.
Yeah, but you know that was only there for like a few minutes and then it was gone.
Yeah, that was literally there and gone, and we were back to Fantastic. Hell, we still had like 20 minutes of Fallout, and just like, hey, here's 20 minutes of Fallout 4. Oh, by the way, it comes out this year.
It's like Doom and Fallout 4 was kind of the big two for theirs.
Yeah.
Yep.
Everything else was there, but not really.
Bethesda literally walked out of the gate, guns blazing, with the freaking super shotgun, saying, "Hey, Doom, check it out. Gore. Kicking freaking feet through faces. That's how we roll." Yeah. Alright, back to the show.
I mean, Bethesda did what should be the pattern that all the rest of them should have followed.
Yeah.
Yep.
Come out the gate with something big, you end with something big. Point
blank. Am I the only one that when I was watching the Microsoft conference, I was just mesmerized by the car and I didn't care about the game?
You weren't the only one. I was like, ooh, new 4 GT. That looks cool. What about Forza? Okay, I don't care.
Forza,
game racing thing. Normally I'm a Forza fan, but I sat there and I watched and I'm like, ooh, car, pretty car. I want it.
To me, hearing what you guys said about them starting with Halo 5, that was probably a bad decision.
Oh.
I don't know. I was kind of okay with it. Microsoft overall, it wasn't the best, but it was a good conference overall compared to the others.
Well, the reason I say that, at this point, Halo is only going on because Microsoft wants it to.
Yep.
Although everyone knows that. I mean, if they want Halo to be the face of Microsoft in terms of gaming, they need to show that. Putting it first, the first slot should be something big, but it shouldn't be something that you want your name to be out there for.
Yeah, where's Halo Online? Where's that fucking Russia-only fucking beta game? Where's that?
I don't
Gears.
Know because it
Gears
wasn't,
even.
I
they
don't could know.
Have started with it.
Yeah.
I don't. I hear me out. I don't know. Because I don't think it was last E3, I think it was the E3 before that with Halo 4, how they started off with Halo 4 and just blew everyone's mind. I think they did well that time, but this time they were trying to go for the same pattern, but it didn't work because they'd already done it.
Yeah. And it's like, well, we already know about Halo 5. Hell, Game Informer, this month before E3, dropped a whole ton of information on Halo 4, so it's like, oh, well, Yeah.
You did it again.
Yeah.
You did it again. Good job.
Well, yeah, Halo 5. Fuck! I keep saying Halo 4, but it's Halo 5! I don't know why!
Anyway, I think you're trying to ignore the fact that Halo 4 exists.
I like Halo 4. That's the problem.
That's the point. Anyway.
But, what I was getting at about Halo 5 shouldn't have started it. Look at Bethesda's. When you think of Bethesda, you typically think of Fallout. You don't think necessarily of Doom.
But when they
Doom's kind of that standalone name where you can say it and
not think of any real company.
Right. You're not really attaching it to a company because you're thinking of the game.
Whereas Fallout, you're
kind of attaching it to Bethesda.
Because nobody's ever done it other than Bethesda.
Yeah.
It's one of those, it's like, to me, Halo should be Microsoft's Fallout. It should be the title that people are at the Microsoft conference for.
It should be their drop the mic, basically.
Yeah. Right. And that's where I kind of feel like that was really screwed up right there. They should have ended with that, not began with that. I mean, yeah, they just bought Gears and got into that. That's where they should go. They should have started with that. That would have been a powerhouse to start with, and then they could have ended with Halo 5 and had that powerhouse end.
I think that I just feel like, okay, yes, Halo is pretty much the face of Microsoft right now. But at the same time, I feel like Microsoft has so many games that are exclusive to them right now that are big that it's hard to discern a true face. Halo kind of got the biggest one out of it, but at the same time, Forza and, crap, the name escapes me.
Okay, I'm going to say this. While it does have Forza, that really only grasps like a really small handful of gamers.
True.
Especially for Microsoft.
True.
So, yes, you can count that as a console exclusive, but I don't think in the sense of the word that should be considered that, because, and I'm not putting down on the community, but there is so small of a group in terms of racing compared to everything else.
Yeah.
That's not a put down, that's just facts there.
Yeah. I feel like
shooter communities like double and triple it easily right out the gate. So by them having Gears, by them having Halo, those really need to be the two bookends of their conferences.
Yeah. Well, I guess that turns us just to the big three who did best out of that.
Honestly, I don't feel like it'd be right to call one out over the others.
Yeah, because I'm like, okay, not Nintendo as much as I love the Star Fox.
Everyone screwed up in their own way.
Yeah.
Yeah. I mean, Nintendo didn't do what everyone thought. So that kind of caused problems. Microsoft, while they had stuff, they might not have went added enough because it didn't seem too rememberable, in my opinion. I mean, I still ain't seen it, but just hearing what was there, it's like, eh. And kind of the same with Sony.
Okay, have we all seen all of the performances, all of them, except for Nintendo, because Nintendo is pretty much the basic thing?
I've seen all three.
Not.
Have we all seen Microsoft and Sony?
I've not seen any of the big three.
Same Microsoft. I've seen like most of Sony. I just skipped through a lot of the whole blah 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 stuff.
Okay, let's judge it on this, Jeremy. Performance Microsoft. In terms of how everything flowed together. Out of 10.
Seven, maybe. I don't know. It's tough. To, like,
I was rolling at a 7, 7.5. Yeah.
I was trying to remember like the exact half flow of Microsoft was, and I'm like 7, I think.
Yeah. Okay. Now to Sony.
6.5, I would say. And that
I would
half
give of... them a straight. I'd give them a straight 6, maybe a 5.5, because they everything died at the middle. It was like all of a sudden everything went from holy crap to
Well, they get a 6.5 from me because of the Uncharted 4 demo, because of it breaking and then them having to restart it, keeping that trend alive of Uncharted 4 demos breaking.
Oh god.
So they get a bonus half a point for having a memorable moment that is a fuck up.
I mean,
do you think they're doing it on purpose now?
Doubt it, because no, that was not on purpose, I would think.
But why did they have to restart it this year? Because it looked like it was working, it just, he wasn't moving.
Probably because the controller was not responding, and they're like, oh, shit, we gotta restart it, and they're like, it's not now, we gotta restart it to get the controller to work, fuck!
I mean, because in the beginning, the entire thing froze, it was just only on PlayStation, and it sat there on the screen.
I must have skipped that part.
You must have, because it sat there for a good 5 minutes while they're just sitting there trying to figure out what's only on PlayStation. There's no sound, there's no nothing, it's just a black screen with only on PlayStation. Everybody's just like, And then in the background, all you heard was one, boo! That's all you heard was one boo in the background, and it was a clear blue. It was a clear boo.
Okay, Nintendo.
I guess the reason the three of them, I'm kind of like meh, is because nothing really stood out.
I'll put it this way: Nintendo had the most fun press conference. You wanna know why?
Nintendo had why?
Muppets.
Oh my god! You're kidding.
Motherfucking Muppets! Iwata, Miyamoto, and Reggie. And he used that to transition half the time. I'm like, yes!
I think I saw a screenshot of that, actually.
Yes, it was. I was like, yes. You know what? Nintendo knows how to have fun. It's like, if we're gonna say, like, who had the most entertaining press conference, oh, fucking Nintendo by a fucking mile. Like, Nintendo knows how to have a fun press conference. Maybe not exciting, maybe not the most surprising, but by God, I enjoyed it the fucking most. But in terms of, like, how it flowed, I'm like, kind of in the same boat as Sony, because it did have those down points for me.
I honestly, in terms of flow, I would have to say Microsoft did better, because while they had their big face in the beginning, it did all kind of, it was stretched out. Like, it wasn't just a clear shot of holy crap to dead. It was just holy, Like, it worked. It was almost like a heartbeat.
Yeah, but I guess Microsoft had the best conference out of the three, but that's just like, no, Bethesda probably has the best conference overall by a fucking mile.
Yeah, Bethesda definitely took all of them.
That was only in terms of the flow. Now
we're not
grading
review
individual parts of the fucking big three.
Just the two things, flow and content. I honestly have to lean more towards Sony.
They are all in the same boat for me, because they all had about the same amount of stuff I gave a damn about.
Same here. I don't have a Sony console, so I mean, even saying that, kind of.
I have to say Sony, because Sony had the more jaw-dropping things. Last Guardian, Final Fantasy VII, that new freaking game Horizon,
But was it enough? I mean, they also had stuff that kind of was meh, too.
Yeah.
Yeah. But honestly, to me, those three games alone were able to pique my interest enough to make me want to get a PS4. Oh. I am interested in getting a PS4, and it's not even because of Uncharted.
Even though it should be, because Uncharted's a fucking great franchise. Fucking Tomb Raider rebooted to become Uncharted.
Yeah. Did they remaster Uncharted for the PS4? Like, all of the Uncharted?
They are. Now.
They are? They are now? Okay.
Yes.
I was about to say, because if that's the case, then I definitely want a PS4, because I'm going to get all the Uncharted games and I'm going to play them all.
Oh, yeah, great. So that means we'll lose him on the Wii U front again.
I'm still iffy on the Wii U. I've never been a big Nintendo fan. Ever since the GameCube. I loved the GameCube, and after that, I lost interest in Nintendo.
Well, I can't blame you for the Wii.
True. Those were dark days. Dark days, but if you can't get into that, at least get into the portable scene, because there's great stuff on the portables.
Like, what portables?
The 3DS?
Oh, yeah.
No, the new 3DS.
No, we ain't talking about the new 3DS, because you don't need a new 3DS. Unless you want Amiibo, unless you don't want to buy the Puck. If you don't want to buy the Amiibo Puck, or you don't care about Amiibos, do not bother with the new 3DS, because it doesn't really matter, unless you want to play the new Xenoblade Chronicles.
Yeah, but I mean, at this point, if you're getting a 3DS, you might as well just go ahead and get the new 3DS, because otherwise you're going to have to shell out for the Puck if you want to use the Amiibos on it.
True.
Yeah.
I mean, at this point, really, you're better off to go ahead.
Yeah. Because, on 3D, we got, what, Fire Emblem Awakening, Kingdom Hearts 3D, Codename Steam, Pokemon...
The plethora of 3DS games.
Well, everything I named was a 3DS game.
I mean, in that way, you just only have to hit the big ones.
Yeah. Xenoblade Chronicles, if you pick up the new 3DS... Like, there's so many good games on the 3DS. If you don't care about the Wii U, go for 3DS, because there's still good games there. Hell, you can pick up friggin' the Hyrule Warriors. And apparently, in order to get King of Red Lions and... fuck, I forgot her name.
Fuck.
You have to buy the game.
No, this is horrible.
Yeah, you have to buy the game to get those two.
Damn it, oh my god, I'm drawing a fucking blank.
Tetra, that's what it is.
Yes, yes.
Tetra, that I'm
wearing. I was gonna say, damn, that's pissing me off.
But if you want those two, you have to buy the game. Also, they dropped in, like, Link to the Past Tunic for Link into Hyrule Warriors today. And we had, a 15-minute, Warzone demo that showed it off. I like Warzone. It's cool. Like, essentially, it's you either get the 1,000 points by doing a variety of objectives, or you, capture all three bases and destroy your opponent's core. And the more you, help, do an assist and kills and all that stuff, you increase your, essentially your supply counter, so you can eventually work your way up to getting the power weapons or a tank, and you call it your own tank. There's no fight for power weapons on the map. No, it's you battle to get the points to summon your shit. So that way, when you summon summon a Banshee, that's your Banshee you summoned, that is your Banshee you're taking out there in the battle, and that is your ass on the line, or your ass making sure that Banshee stays alive, unless you pawn it off to somebody else.
Hmm.
Yeah, Warzone's not cool. Also, they had a cool, explanation thing where, for the HoloLens, they brought you into a room to a table, and they had, Palmer... explain Warzone with you wearing the HoloLens, and it was cool. Halo Cannon's got a video up showing it off. But yeah, press conferences, everything had good stuff in all of them that I was interested in, but there's moments, but there's not like a standout conference outside of Bethesda, I feel like.
I kind of feel the same. It's like, honestly, EA and Square probably had two weaker-ended ones. And I mean in as far as content.
Yeah.
Because I know your thoughts on Ubisoft's performance side of things.
To be fair, that's only the host. Ubisoft, I think, did all right outside of host.
But
I still don't see why you hate her so much.
I don't hate her. I just don't care for her because I don't think she's funny. She's not funny. She's trying too hard to be funny.
Yeah, I caught that too. But, yeah. I kind of feel like content-wise, anyhow, they all were on the same page. Except for some of the things that EA and Square did.
Yeah.
Like what?
All the sports stuff, but apparently, like, the sports stuff is good for sports people, apparently. Like, I still have my problems with the new Need for Speed. Mass Effect was a fucking CGI trailer, and I'm like, alright, if you're bringing a CGI trailer...
Shut up! I'm getting to talk about it now!
If we're bringing a CGI trailer for Mass Effect, I don't fucking care. Show up with some actual gameplay. Don't 2 year in a row me bullshit and bullshit be like, we're working on Mass Effect 4 and here's some stupid bullshit move video to try to hype it up even though we got nothing to show for it.
It gave a little bit more idea into what it's going to be about.
Sort yes!
Of. But it
except
gave
we
us
already
no
knew all
idea.
That.
But it gave us no idea on if they're doing anything different with the gameplay. If there's
that's
any kind of
another,
new enemies or anything like that. This is freaking E3. This is the biggest moment for their game.
Yeah.
You know, it's not going to be for next E3. We don't know if they're going to freaking delay it or not. They're probably going to delay it just so that they can show it off at E3 before they release it. I mean, for God's sake, Arkham Knight did it.
Yeah, and that was stupid. I don't care about Mass Effect Andromeda until they have something to fucking show for it. I don't care. I'm sorry, Bioware. You burned me with 3. You gotta show up and you gotta give me something to be excited about. I can't just be like, oh, it's Mass Effect. It's gonna be good. Because no. No. I got burned. I ain't being burned again. Also, I'm taking a look at an article on screen, so you're gonna be seeing something I may or may not talk about. Because this is how I normally do things.
You could use the title card.
But I have to fucking do fucking
not
Firefox.
If you just click it over. If you check it over it, then you don't. If you uncheck freaking Firefox, then you'll have to redo it.
Give me a second. There we go. It's there now.
Even though people are reselling. By the other article, by the way. You see? That worked. And I guarantee when you pull that freaking card back, you won't have to resize it.
That is cool.
Well, what? I know the title says that apparently the Final Fantasy VII Remake story could deviate from the original, but nothing in the article suggests this from what I'm reading.
So, I have a little information on Battlefront.
Is it something we already know about?
Depends. Did you talk about Battle Beyond?
No, what's Battle Beyond?
Okay. DICE decided to come up with this really cool concept with Battlefront. Involving the surrounding area. They decided that because the multiplayer is going to be so big in the game, because everything is going to be so centered around the battle and how it's played out,
they decided to make things change depending on who is winning and who is not throughout the game. For example, on Tatooine, when you watch the trailer, when you watch the E3 trailer this year, you notice that in the sky there's an Imperial starship that is crashing into Tatooine. They spoke and said because of the fact that the Rebel Alliance is dominating that particular map, that particular Tatooine map, the visual representation is the flaming Star Destroyer sinking into the surface. If the Rebel Alliance was not dominating, the Star Destroyer would be visible, however, it would not be crashing, it wouldn't be burning, and it all changes based on how much they're dominating, how well they're doing in the game.
That sounds...
So the environment changes around them.
That sounds cool. Also, I'm just going to say this right now, literally fuck the PC Gamer press conference right now, because you know what's happening?
What?
It's still going!
Oh my god!
Bear in mind, people, they started at 9 o'clock Eastern Standard Time. It is now almost 11:30. They have been going for 2.5 hours! They delayed it an hour!
Wow.
Longest con ever. There was somebody in the chat that said that.
Well, it didn't help none that they wanted to take 30 minutes talking about freaking graphics cards.
Twice.
Yeah.
Twice, mind
yeah,
you.
Yeah, twice. Yeah.
Fucking bullshit.
So, there's an hour of it.
We're going to condense that down into like 20 minutes, I swear.
Everyone is still begging for Half-Life 3.
Oh, they better have something by the end of this or they're gonna fucking riot. I would fucking riot. Like,
Half-Life
fuck this conference! Dun, 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 dun.
Half-Life 3 and Portal 3.
I've been demanding wrestling chants this entire
week. Wait, final guest.
Is it Gabe Newell? Because if it's not Gabe Newell, I don't fucking care.
Everyone's yelling Gaben.
It's not, is it? I don't care about the PC Gamer Conference. Who is it?
It's No Man's Sky!
We're moving on.
They will riot.
Oh my god.
Let's start a riot. A riot. That is off key for that song.
Because everybody is yelling riot. Everyone is yelling riot in the chat.
Now we get a wrestling chant? Fuck you people. I wanted wrestling chants during the fucking Nintendo World Championships, but no one wanted to do them.
Ooh, everyone is just yelling riot.
Okay.
I was wanting a fucking Aaron chant, but no one was gonna do it. You know Aaron would play that would play up to it, but I'd be like, fuck yeah, go for it.
Everyone is just hating on it now. Everyone's just hating it because of no.
Well, do we want to vote for worst conference? Because I think right now they might have just took it home.
See, 2.5 hours of nonsense? Yeah.
Two and a half hours of nothing. It was just a freaking talk show that had nothing to show for it. Oh my god.
What's
Everybody's
bad?
There are people yelling, go Xbox!
What's bad about this was the fact that Square did not have a good conference either. Yeah,
they did better. Theirs at least had someone go, thank you, after the Kingdom Hearts 3 demo, and they didn't fucking riot.
Oh. Jeez.
Anyway, we got two last little articles to talk about before we head off. First up, we essentially got confirmation that Star Wars is not going to come to LEGO Dimensions. Why?
Because it's in Infinity.
Pretty much. That's exactly the reason. Yeah. President of production, John Vignocci? Vignocci?
I can't see it. Hang on. Let me get to it.
V-I-G-N-O-C-C-A.
Vignocci, yeah, thank you, Peter.
It sounds Italian, so I'm thinking Vignocci.
I'm trying to find it.
It's at the top of the... It's in the first paragraph.
Oh, I'm on the
right
wrong... I'm on the wrong
if
one.
If you'd open the right article.
First paragraph, you know, top one.
Last two articles.
Vignocci, I think. Okay. Silent.
Let's see. Don't count on it, he said when asked about this when it came to the Legend of Dimensions, and explained that introducing Star Wars to the conventions would cannibalize the Disney Infinity business. Good for everyone except Disney Infinity. So the
pretty
exact
much.
Same reason Lego can't get Marvel, even though they own the Lego license to both franchises.
Mm-hmm.
Pretty much.
Added, and he also added that Disney Infinity is truer to the filmmaker's vision, at least in the play sets. The license doesn't want franchises mixing together, which is the whole point of LEGO Dimensions as a toy box mode, and the toy box mode of Disney Infinity, so, yeah. Double standard there, son.
Pretty much.
And then the usual spiel about, you know, the stuff that's going to come out. So yeah, that confirms what I thought and why Marvel's not going to appear in LEGO Dimensions and why they went with DC. But they're still going to make LEGO Marvel games.
Great.
Marvel's in Infinity, so we can't do it. Even though Nintendo's like, you know what we need to do? We need to partner up with Skylanders and make our own and have like Nintendo exclusive Skylanders for Wii U. We ain't afraid to do that.
What's horrible about that is the fact that, truthfully, it wouldn't hurt Infinity. Because I would venture to say the LEGO Dimensions setup would not be the exact same as the Infinity setup. Therefore, they would still be selling the figures for both games.
Yeah. Yeah, hell, like, the Skylanders and the Amiibo setups are different because they have different functionalities.
The only difference would legitimately be that by Disney doing this, they are not going to be able to tap into the LEGO Dimensions money that is going to be printed.
Well, they're already tapping into the LEGO money, so it all works out in the end.
Yeah, pretty much.
Okay. Yeah, LEGO games never do great.
Fair point.
But LEGO Dimensions probably going to do really good.
No, I would not like to participate in the survey.
I think Dimensions is going to be that one LEGO game where it's like, yeah, you know how everyone gripes and complains all the time about LEGO games? Yep, here's the one where you guys are going to shut right the fuck up and play it.
Yeah. Well, Tommy, I know we're both out on the Animal Crossing amiibos, and I don't know if you know about the 8-bit Mario amiibos that are going to be for Mario Maker.
Really?
Yep. It's essentially like a giant 8-bit Mario that's in classic, like, Mario 1 colors and then modern Mario colors. And they both, like, make Mario super huge in Mario Maker. And it's like, on this unique, like, warp pipe stand that says, like, Mario 30th Anniversary. I'm like, that's cool! As, like, a little celebration for 30th Anniversary. So, I don't know if you're in for that, but I do know an amiibo that's in production, that's in the prototype phase that you're gonna be into.
That I will order as soon as they allow pre-orders.
An Arwing amiibo.
Uh huh.
And it gets better.
But I want freaking Fox and Falco.
Don't worry, I think Fox is getting like a second run.
It better.
But it gets better. Because you know what they also say about the Arwing?
What?
It might be transformable.
How so?
Arwing to Walker. Because the R-Wing literally transforms into the Walker. And that's something they're contemplating for the R-Wing amiibo. And Falco will be in time. Will be out in time by the time. Will be out by the time Star Fox comes out, which means Star Fox is coming out this year. Woohoo! I see a lot of different prototypes of R-Wing Amiibo, but we're not sure if when it will be ready to be announced for sale. Although, as official confirmation, Mewtwo's coming out this year as DLC Amiibo. The other three DLC Fighter Amiibos are coming out next year, based off the timeline we got.
Hmm.
Let's see. I'm not sure you're aware of the Amiibo storage situation. I'm sure you're aware of the Amiibo storage situation, even with the back orders and repeat orders. We kind of have our hands full. Earlier, we talked about how the 3D model of the R-Wing will actually transform into a two-legged walker in the game. We have an actual model, and we're thinking how much it would actually cost to make. When it's transformable. Can we actually do that? We're thinking about a lot of different things right now. Holy fuck, if we have an R-Wing that transforms into the Walker and it's an Amiibo, fuck yeah. I don't care what the price is, I'm in. I'm fucking sold.
You know, if cost comes into play and they think it'd make it too far out of reach, there is another option they could go, and they've already shown that they can do that.
Do the whole multiple poses thing that Mr. Game & Watch has?
Right. Have an R-Wing Amiibo where the R-Wing's the default on the base, but you get the Walker that you can swap out with it.
Yeah, I'm freaking in.
I mean, that might be something that would be a good cost-effective means, and it's something we know can exist in the Amiibos.
Like,
so I would be fine with that.
I don't know what it would do in Star Fox, or what it would be, what its like compatibility would be. But I still don't care because it's an R-Wing, and hell, I'll buy it. Hell, I'll still buy the World of Nintendo Fox when that comes out. That has the R-Wing with it.
Well, okay. I've got an idea. This might not be what happens. Okay. We already know they're taking some things out of Star Fox 2.
Right.
What if the R-Wing Amiibo maybe unlocked another R-Wing that you can use?
That would be cool. Because that goes in line with like my thought of like Amiibo compatibility of, hey, before we actually saw the game, where it's like, you get the classic R-Wing. Because I would figure they would go with like a more, like a different R-Wing, but it's like classic R-Wing. Like,
yeah,
hardcore classic R-Wing. So unless we get Assault, which, how many people want to play as the Assault R-Wing, even though I think it looks cool?
I think, isn't the Assault R-Wing not really too much of a change either?
No, it is different. It's completely different.
It is?
Uh-huh.
I never noticed that.
Like, let me pull it up.
Glock, your echo gets worse and worse as the day progresses.
Oh, sorry, I was too close to the computer. I was playing my phone game.
Like, let me see if I can pull up a picture real quick, and I'll show it on stream. Where is it? It looks vastly different. Does no one have a picture of it? Come on, show me a picture. Only that's going to probably be weapons and items. That's not going to have it. Isn't this fun?
Pretty much. My computer.
That's the R-Wing from Assault.
Do Gotta love Twitch delay.
Yep. But yeah, you see, it's a vastly different. Even the Landmaster's still vastly different. Yeah, I was about to say, even the Landmaster's vastly different. It doesn't have tank treads, it has, like, off-road tires. But still, I don't like how many people want the Assault R-Wing. One day, we'll be able to continue this conversation.
Hmm.
See? It's not the classic R-Wing at all.
True.
But since we're going, like, super hardcore in the classic R-Wing, I don't know if that's an option anymore. Because it's not a selling point for many people. So yeah, that's cool and awesome, and I can't wait.
I'm kind of hoping that they do something neat with the amiibos with it.
Yeah.
And not just do something like they did with Captain Toad's Treasure Tracker.
Yeah.
Where, like, every amiibo gives a one-up.
You know what they could do? Like, Samus and Falcon, they could give you access to, like... like either
their ships,
yeah, their ships, or a ship based off their ships. Like, you get a Blue Falcon inspired vehicle to play with, or you get, like, I don't know, I don't think the, Samus's ship has a name.
I don't think it does. I don't think it canonically does. I'm sure it does.
Yeah, somewhere.
Yeah.
Yeah, something based off her ship or her actual ship, because, well, it's either the Blue Falcon or the Great Falcon, I think? Which is a little too big for Star Fox. Or, hell, you can put in, like, Meta Knight and have his, like, something based off, like, his carrier.
Huh.
Or, but I can't think of anyone else who's spacefaring. Like, something based off Mega Man if they want to go that route, because why not? Maybe something Warp Star kind of with Kirby. Like, there's ideas here. And it doesn't have to be, yeah, like a jet. It could be like a land vehicle to kind of replace the Landmaster. Or it could be like the gyrocopter. It could replace the gyrocopter and be like a more of a floating vehicle.
If there's enough use for that. Because if you think back to Star Fox 64, which I know... really, you probably shouldn't if you're trying to compare this to that.
I know. There's like two Landmaster levels and one, like, Blue Marine level.
Yeah.
I know. But what they said is, like, there's stuff hidden in all the levels that you would require having to play vehicles, so I assume, like, certain levels can be replayed with different vehicles.
I would hope.
Yeah.
And God, if we both get that horrible idea, will ensue.
Yeah. But yeah, that, I think that'll call us out day two for us.
I just thought of something.
What?
Did they announce any kind of multiplayer mode for it?
I think they said no. I'm not sure.
Damn it. Because online multiplayer would be nice for that.
I'm checking real quick. Because no, I think it was something else they said, like, no single player on. Yeah, okay, yeah, no online multiplayer mode.
Aww.
Like, that's outright confirmed. Sucks. That sucks, but it's like, okay, that's, alright.
Aww.
Yeah.
Why, Nintendo? Why don't you want us to break the Nintendo Network more?
Because it's fragile.
Well, they need to make it less fragile.
Alright, I think we can close out there. That's day two for us. Tomorrow, we should have more, like, showroom floor, like, demo talk, and more just general talk of whatever we've caught video-wise. Hopefully, because there really wasn't that much today from what I caught. Like, there was Warzone from Halo 5, but that was it. And that was like a 15-minute demo, and I'm trying not to have us watch 1,001 videos for E3 coverage. Because A, everyone else is doing that, and B, I don't know, I feel like we should be giving our opinions more than just watching that stuff and giving snarky comments about it.
True.
So, tomorrow, more showroom coverage. Glock shall be, unfortunately, not with us as he's run out of internet time. So, he disappears back into the ether once more as he will find a way back again at some point.
Who, maybe?
Yes.
Yes.
Yeah.
You'll disappear back into the ether once more.
I'll be back someday.
Okay. So, I guess, for Glock and for Tommy, I'm Peace. Good night, everybody. We'll see you tomorrow with our final day of E3 nonsense coverage. And then we can go back to doing normal things.
Yes.
Bye.
Bye, everyone.
As always, you can find the Gaming Saloon on our site at tgsnetwork.org. You can also find us on our social medias on Twitter at TG Saloon, on Google Plus at google.com/plus TGS TGSR.org, and on YouTube at youtube.com/TG Saloon. Till next time.